Welcome back. This is County Talk. I'm Godfrey Oman. In this edition, we are in Bungoma County and we are in Kandui constituency, Musikoma ward that covers approximately 44 kilometers square. It has a population of 37,933 going by the 2009 census. But again, since then till now, the population has grown. Musikoma ward consists of Namasanda and South Kandui sub-locations in Bungoma County. I beg your pardon. Now, and the guest that we are having today is an aspirant for member of county assembly to represent the people of Musikoma ward. He is none other than Isaiah Baraza, who wants to represent the people of Musikoma ward. Now, when you've declared your decision that you are going to vie for this position, what are your agendas? Because you cannot just tell us you're going to vie. What are you bringing on table? What is your agenda for Musikoma ward?
The first thing is about governance. Mm-hmm. We need good governance. Mm-hmm. We need good governance. Good governance must involve the people. That's the first thing.
Yes.
Because if we want to do any project, we must first have involve the people, talk to them, see what are their needs and what are the resources that we have and what do we need to get from the other places. Mm-hmm. That's the first thing. Mm-hmm. The second agenda is to look at our roads. Mm-hmm. I told you that Musikoma people should not be poor. These people, they are poor because they have not opened up the area. Yet mm-hmm. It borders Bungoma Township. Mm-hmm. You see, when you open up these roads, there are people who are going to build, for example, rental houses. Mm-hmm. People will be selling skumas to the new migrants to the town. Mm-hmm. Then they have another agenda. Bungoma County now population is growing very fast, especially Musikoma, because the headquarters of Bungoma County is in Bungoma Town.
Yes.
And Bungoma Town borders Musikoma.
Yes.
So we have so many people coming from other sub-counties and constituencies within. Mm-hmm. So we need to plan for that. We need to plan for the population. Mm-hmm. We need to get in touch as a county assembly, mm-hmm. get in touch with the national assembly and do some serious town planning. Mm-hmm. Because the town is expanding very fast. Mm-hmm. So we need a good plan for the town. Currently, Bungoma Town, I cannot say that it's well you can talk about it being mm-hmm. planned. Mm-hmm. You look at the drainage, for example, mm-hmm. or the routes, for example, areas around Tulienge, mm-hmm. Sio, mm-hmm. Namisi, mm-hmm. Siritani, there's a lot of gully erosion happening and there's nothing proper thing being done about that. Mm-hmm. Then we look about education. Musikoma needs at least a boarding school. Mm-hmm. It needs a boarding school. Mm-hmm. Musikoma world does not have a boarding school, mm-hmm. even a single one.
But why should we have a boarding school if we do not have enough schools? Do we have enough schools in Musikoma that can accommodate the people, the pupils or the students at Musikoma ward?
Yeah, the schools are. I cannot talk about them being enough, mm-hmm. because the very few that we have are day schools, mm-hmm. and when I speak of starting boarding schools in Musikoma ward, it means that those ones that are now day schools, they are going to be elevated into boarding schools. We are going to get with the county government, mm-hmm. because there are many resources through education kit. We get shamba, farm, we buy with the local community, of course, by involving the people. Mm-hmm. Then we elevate those schools into boarding schools. And you know the advantages of some place having a boarding school. Even the economy of that area is going to grow. Mm-hmm. After that, we now need to look at health. At the moment, Musikoma has very few dispensaries, mm-hmm. and the ones that are not operational. So my first job in 2017 is to make sure that they start operating. Mm-hmm. That's one. Second is to add more, because in Musikoma this is like malaria. I have been hearing since I was born, but people walk long distances. The main streams, rivers, Yo, rivers, Liu, Namisi, and all those rivers, mm-hmm. Which is very dangerous. Even sometimes we lose children. Sometimes because of shortage again of schools, you find that some pupils have to go many distances, long distances. So by the end of the day, even we lose some of them, they are carried away by floods. Eh? Mm-hmm. So it becomes really fatal.
And you've talked about issues of health sectors within Musikoma Ward. You've said the current dispensaries that you have right now are not operational.
Yeah.
And you want to make them operational. So does it mean that we do not have health workers in these?
No, we have so many people. In fact, at the moment as I speak, we have many professionals who are nurses. At the moment, we also have KMTZ College in Bungoma Town.
Mm-hmm.
And so Musikoma is a neighbor. Uh-huh. So these people can even come in and help the professionals we already have, the already qualified nurses.
But this hospital equipped? Are they equipped?
They are not well equipped. And that's why I'm saying someone is sleeping on the job.
Mm-hmm.
These are things that everyone knows. For example, look at the beds, the X-ray machines, even just to do some scanning and it's to be done, you have to be sent to a private institution, which is very expensive for the common man.
Mm-hmm.
And these are things that actually, at the moment, we are speaking them so softly.
Mm-hmm.
Someone may think they're not so serious.
Mm-hmm.
What we want to bring in Musikoma, agenda number 5, is human dignity.
Mm-hmm.
Dignity.
Mm-hmm.
People need clean water. We want to tackle those simple issues.
Mm-hmm.
Don't want to talk about an airport. I don't want to talk about maybe an industry.
Mm-hmm.
I want human dignity.
Mm-hmm.
People should get clean water through the community mobilization,
mm-hmm.
and through the money that will be allocated actually,
mm-hmm.
through the Ministry of Environment and special special docket.
Mm-hmm.
We can do these things. And make sure that people have some clean water. We can make sure that the local Mwananchi, whatever he plans to do, is implemented, or what all their views are taken into account. You know, when you're not listened to, it means that someone does not care about you. You don't have dignity in their eyes.
Mm-hmm.
Now,
and now you see, you say you want to bring back dignity to the human being around Musikoma.
Yeah, let me just add,
mm-hmm.
when you talk about the human dignity, mm-hmm. at the moment we discover that because of the current, the wars that we sometimes and in strifes that we experience in neighboring countries like Uganda and South Sudan,
yes.
it happens that Bungoma County is a border county.
Yes.
So we have so many South Sudanese now in Bungoma
mm-hmm.
County,
mm-hmm.
and actually in Musikoma
yes.
and township.
Mm-hmm.
Those people need to be protected. We need to have a clear way of knowing how many are there in Musikoma, how are they living. Because one of them came and complained to me if we can do something for them, because I'm told they leave 20 people in a single room.
You know,
that's an issue that even the national government should be aware of. And as a representative of the people at Musikoma, that's an issue that I think is about social justice.
Mm-hmm.
Currently, we have an issue about refugees being taken
out
and all that.
That is the question that I wanted to ask you. You want to accommodate refugees within your ward, and the national government is saying that we are sending them back because they should go back, build their country, let their country be stable. And you here in Musikoma, you are planning to do something for them. You know, you will be opening another Dadaab in Musikoma.
No. Mm. The issue with the people need to really understand the challenges that the counties in border counties have.
Mm-hmm.
For example, in Coast,
mm-hmm.
we have people whom they say that they are from Malawi
mm-hmm.
or Mozambique,
mm-hmm.
and they're the best, that they should go back, they should not go back.
Mm-hmm.
So the question is this: someone is of third generation.
Mm-hmm.
She has lived there. He knows Kenya's the only country, the only people, friends, everything is in Kenya.
Mm-hmm.
So when you want to send him or her away, mm-hmm. where do you want to go? Because it's a human being. I think we need to dignify life. But you see, there's something unique about these other people.
Mm-hmm.
This is not like Northeastern. Have you heard of Gurneds in Bungoma? Oh,
maybe. But all the same.
What I mean.
Yes.
If at all they have to be repatriated,
mm-hmm.
then they should be through a proper channel. But now that they are here, we need to do something for them. We cannot let the humanity languish in such conditions.
Yes,
we need to do something for them.
I agree with you, but we have to understand one thing. If we have refugees in Bungoma, we have Kakuma refugee camp, where they are supposed to stay. We have refugee camp in Dadaab, where they are supposed to stay.
Mm.
Why, as a leader that also believe in the government of the day that is elected, because we have to work with the government of
yes.
the day.
Yeah.
Why don't you use a proper channel to lead them to Dadaab or lead them to Kakuma, where the other refugees are there instead of Musikoma? Because again, This one will bring in issues of insecurity within Bungoma. And you know, as the CS says, Interior CS, Kaiseri says that there comes a time where the national interest comes first. So we should be very careful with the people of Musikoma instead of accommodating people that we don't know. And we have places for them. Places like Kakuma, places like Dadaab.
Let me just cut you short. You look at Bungoma or the border counties.
Yes.
The government is just becoming presentations. The government is just becoming hypocritical. The government knows that the border counties have people who reside in both maybe Uganda and Kenya, who's in Tanzania and Kenya, mm-hmm. South Sudan and Kenya.
Mm-hmm.
They know those people, and mm-hmm. they do happen.
Yes.
It's in the public domain knowledge.
Mm-hmm.
It's there.
Mm-hmm.
But now, we are talking about people who came because of war. Maybe there are people who came to Bungoma during that time of Milton Obote's wars,
mm-hmm.
and those schools in Uganda.
Mm-hmm.
They have lived here all this time. Their parents died.
Mm-hmm.
We have don't know these children. That's a challenge that now Musikoma has. Even that the current MCA is not aware that it exists. And that's why I feel that given an opportunity,
mm-hmm.
I'll find a way out how to deal with that issue with through collaboration with the national government.
Mm-hmm. Making policies to run the entire county are responsibilities of an MCA, member of county assembly. And let's say you are elected by the people of Musikoma to go and represent them in the county assembly of Bungoma. These are policies that will be passing to ensure that the dignity of the people that you represent is well taken care of. How are you going to ensure that the policies that you are going to present before the floor of the house will represent their interest so that we have a better living? Because you've said, and I quote you, have you said that the people of Musikoma are poor. How are you going to do with these policies to ensure that you elevate them from poverty?
I think we need to proper legislation.
Mm-hmm.
When you look at the tax laws that maybe at the moment are there, they do not encourage people to start businesses and to be self-reliant. They don't encourage people to do business because like all the profits they go back to the government, are taken back in terms of taxes.
Mm-hmm.
So we need proper legislation so that as even our people do business, they
mm-hmm.
benefit from that.
Mm-hmm.
Apart from legislation, we need also to consult our people. We need sober, diplomatic, and consultative leadership,
mm-hmm.
so that as you engage the people, you will know what they really need, so that you don't come with a project, as I said earlier,
mm-hmm.
that won't help in any way
mm-hmm.
to the people. And this is what I want to say. What Musikoma is facing now is what the country is facing at the moment. What the country is facing at the moment is economic problem.
Mm-hmm.
It's not political problem.
Mm-hmm.
We have already political problems. I think we want them through the new constitution. And sometimes when you look at what's happening in this country, you think that some people are getting it wrong. The problems that we have in this country now, the economic problem. People need food on the table. People need to water. People need to dress well. People need to go for leisure. You know, people think that it's only wazungus or tourists who are supposed to go to Mount Elgon National Park,
mm-hmm.
or who are supposed to go to Sango Hills. No.
Mm-hmm.
Or to go to CEO Resort.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
So we need to empower them in a certain
mm-hmm.
way economically so that these people can enjoy life.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
But and again, by doing that, it will be creating a revenue to the county so that the county government could be also helping the people for service delivery.
Yeah.
Now, you've talked about issues of drainage, issues of clean water in Musikoma. And let's narrow it down to Musikoma.
Mm.
You said Musikoma is bordering Township Ward, which is Bungoma Town.
Yes.
And many people who work in Bungoma also stays in Musikoma.
Yeah.
So, matters of drainage, matters of clean water, because again, if I work in an office from morning to evening, I need to go back, not to run to the river to go and fetch water.
Yes.
We need piped water.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about.
So, as an MCA, Musikoma Ward, 44 kilometers,
mm.
how are you going to ensure that the entire population, the 30, the 40 and above, 40,000 and above population are with piped waters, electricity has reached them. How are you going to do that?
I think as I speak now, it's the people in Musikoma, actually, for example, when I talk about electricity, I think the national government needs to be applauded. As I speak now, those people who stay near the lines, the power have been dropped. I think that one, the government, the national government should be applauded for the good work. So, for us, as we come in 2017, now the people's leader, the new leadership.
Yes.
You see, the reason why I'm vying actually is because I said I want to bring something new. And this something new is to change the perspective about politics. That politics, it should be God worshipping. We need to empower someone such that even if he sees an MP or an MCA or a center passing around, that person does not need to run after him or her to be given 50 shillings, 100 shilling. And that's one way through electrification. Through electrification, what's happening at the moment, people can be able to do welding so that they do... they get some money. They can do pumping, irrigation, using that electricity. Because I told you, Musikoma has good soils, hot and wet climate. We have plenty of rain. Even that irrigation will only be needed maybe in a few, like 1 month dry period that we experience. Then we need also to shift our mind in Musikoma. And this I think I want to be clear to my residents and my people. We need to change the way we look at agriculture. We need to shift from substance farming and start doing serious farming. I'm starting to think that I think it's high time we do away with cash crop farming in Musikoma Ward. Cash crop like sugarcane, which we plant, and maize, the kind of money that it brings in per year when you do a calculation. Suppose you plant something like watermelons, because areas like Sio, you know, we have a Sio basin. There's a river that runs there, the Sio River with through Musikoma, Sio basin. It can fetch some good more money. If we do kales, and I have told you that more people are coming to live there, they need boga, they need vegetables, they need fruits. It will be better, and you can make a good selling out of it than if we do this kind of cash cropping. So I think our people there, we need to change and embrace horticulture and shift away from maize and sugarcane. But I'm not saying that they shift totally, but because we have the industries also, Nzoia Sugar, which we must make sure that we keep it alive and supplied with raw material. So even as you, my farmers, as you till your land, make sure some part of the land you put it under horticulture.
We